are my dear darlings doing? I hope you are all keeping fine. So my dear students, in today's class we are going to discuss a grammar topic which is voice. Please keep revising your literature portions. It is very, very important. Read your textbooks also thoroughly. Now my dear darlings, in English we all know that construction of sentences happens primarily on what the subject is doing. At this point, the verb becomes very important because verb describes the actions done by the subject. Isn't it, my children? Yes. Now, an action can be done, an action can be received. So, based on this, in English, we have two kinds of sentences, which is active voice and passive voice. It has nothing to do with the voice or the sound that we are making, nothing regarding that. Voice discusses about the kind of action being done. Let me repeat, it explains to us about whether an action is being done or whether an action is being received. Now, I know that is a little bit confusing. To explain that, let me just give you an example, a very simple example. The principal congratulated Manu. Another sentence I will give you, Manu was congratulated by the principal. Two sentences which are having the similar kind of meaning. Now in the first sentence, the subject principal is doing the action. Isn't it, children? The principal congratulated Manu. So principal is doing the action of giving congratulations. In the second sentence, what is the subject? Subject is Manu. And what is happening to Manu? Manu is receiving the action. Manu was congratulated by the principal. Have you understood the difference? In the first sentence, the principal is doing the action. In the second sentence, Manu is receiving the action. So the first sentence, where an action is being done by the subject, we can call that sentence as active voice. And in the second sentence, where an action is being received by the subject, you can call that as passive voice. It is as simple as that. Now, the most important part of active voice and passive voice, a question which can be asked for your exams, is to change the sentences from active voice to passive voice. That is the kind of questions that will come for your exams. Now, changing the sentences from active voice to passive voice, there is a rule to be used. Now, again, we know that sentences can also be identified in the name of tenses. We have already studied tenses in our previous class. So, you know what present tense and its forms are, past tense and its forms are, and future tense and its forms are. Now, each tense form, when you are changing it into passive voice, there are certain kinds of rules to be applied. And my children, you have to learn and remember these rules very well. So, with full concentration on, let us go into the changing of active voice to passive voice based on the tense forms. So, my dear children, let us look into the rules that we are going to apply when we are changing sentences from active voice to passive voice based on the tense forms. So, first of all, let us look into simple present tense. I have got two sentences on the board. Let us look into these two sentences. The first sentence, which is in active voice, is Diya eats chocolates. The second sentence, which is in the passive voice, is chocolates are eaten by Diya. So here we notice that both the sentences are having sentence, it will be changed into the past participle form. Always it is like that in passive voice. So two general rules we have learned. One more general rule we will learn. Now, here we have here, here we have here. Eats, we said it is converted into eat. Chocolates is also here. Can you find any extra word in this sentence? Yes, there is this word by over here. Okay, so the third rule is that when you are changing active voice to passive voice, this word has to always come before the object. Again, this is applicable for all the passive voice sentences. So, three general rules we have studied. Can you just quickly write it down on the board? So, my dears, here I have the rules written down for you. The first rule is subject in the active voice will be the object in the passive voice. And the similar kind of change, object in the active voice will become the subject in the passive voice. Then the next rule is verb is always in the past participle form. Very, very important thing to remember. The word by is added before the object in the passive voice. These are the four general rules that you need to remember. Memorize these rules. It's very, very important. Okay. Now, if the verb is always in the past participle form, then how do we identify whether the sentence is in present form, past form or future form? The tense. How can we identify the tense? For that comes the next rule, which is, have you noticed this word are being added over here? Now, when you are changing a simple present tense to passive voice, always the words is or are is added before the main verb. Now, how do we know whether it is is or are to be added? It depends upon the subject. Okay? If the subject is singular, we add is. Subject is plural, we have are. So this is how this sentence construction is being done. So my children, the rule to be applied for changing an active voice to passive voice in simple present tense is subject plus is or are based on the subject plus verb in the past participle form plus the word by same word we are using, run. Now, present perfect has what change will happen to that when it comes into passive? Here, along with has, we are adding the word be. Okay? So, be is the word we are adding to make sure that the sentence is a present perfect tense. Has or have according to the subject. So, let us now write down the rule for present perfect tense. The rule is subject plus has or have. If the subject is plural, we will add have. When the subject is singular, we will add has. Has or have plus be plus verb in the past participle form by and then the object. So, this is the rule for present perfect tense.
We have got one more tense form in present tense, which is the present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect continuous tense, when you are changing it from active voice to passive voice, there is no change. You will change it only with the general rules. Is it clear? So, three tense forms in present tense only we need to change, is the simple present tense, present continuous and present perfect tense. So, all the rules are given to you. Memorize them, learn them very well and remember them also. Keep working hard and be good children. Have a wonderful day, my dear darlings.